Starting a blog is easy if you follow the steps I'm going to show you in this video. Hey digital learners, welcome to the channel. If you are new here, I'm Rahul from learndigitalwithrahul.com. And to be honest with you, starting a blog is the best thing that ever happened to my life. After playing around with some free blogs and other platforms to write, I started my first professional blog as a teenager back in 2013. And since then, I have been able to take my blogging journey to unexpected heights, achieving many things I had wished for in my life. But it all started with a blog. I want to transform your life as well the same way. That is why I want you to stick around and keep watching until the end of this video. Because in today's video, I'll walk you through the step-by-step process of creating your own professional blog, even if you don't have any technical skills. Alright, now without any further ado, let's get started. In order to start your own professional blog, you will need three things: a domain name, a hosting server, and a content management system. A domain name is the web address of your blog, just like digitalcreatoracademy.com, which is the domain name of my website. While a hosting server is like renting space on the internet where you keep and host your website or blog files. However, a content management system or CMS is the place where you manage your website. A CMS allows you to see and manage the back end of your website, so that you can decide the way the front end of your website looks. I have discussed all this in detail on my blog. Check out the video description below for the link to that article. Alright, now let's quickly start creating your WordPress blog. The first step of creating a blog is choosing the right web hosting service. And this is the most crucial step. When it comes to web hosting service providers, there are many cheap as well as costly web hosting companies available in the market. And to be honest, I have tried most of them. But one of my favorite for beginners is Bluehost. It's because of the very affordable price and the simplicity it offers, along with the amazing 24/7 live chat support. You can either waste several weeks or even months in researching for the various web hosting services, or you can bet on my recommendation and get started right away with Bluehost. The choice is yours. Alright, now that you're still watching, that means you don't want to waste your time. Instead, you want to quickly start blogging in the next few minutes. So let's jump on my computer and let me show you step-by-step instruction. First, open your web browser and type learndigitalwithrahul.com/hosting in the URL field. Then hit enter. Before we proceed, a quick disclaimer. This is my affiliate link, and if you decide to purchase, I'll receive a small commission at no extra cost to you. In fact, just because you are using my affiliate link, I'll also provide you with some bonuses. Check out the video description below for more details regarding how you can get additional bonuses from me. Alright, once you are on this page, click on the Get Started Now button. And on the next screen, you'll be prompted to select your hosting plan. Bluehost offers three types of shared hosting plans: Basic, Plus, and Choice Plus. If you need only one blog, choose Basic plan. However, if you need to host more than one blog, you may choose other plans depending upon your needs and budget. I would choose the Basic plan because I need to host only one domain. And if I need more, I can always upgrade later. Once you choose the plan, on the next screen, you will get these options. Here, you need to select your domain name. If you are starting from scratch and don't have a registered domain yet, you can type your desired name here. Then choose the domain extension you want, like .com, .org, .net, etc. Alternatively, you also get the option to use your existing domain name. For example, if you have already registered your domain name from other places, you can enter that here in this field and then click Next. And you also get the option to skip all this for now, so that you can grab the hosting account quickly and decide your domain later. But since they offer a free domain for 1 year along with the hosting plan, so I want to register a new domain. Therefore, I'll choose this option and click Next to see if my desired domain name is available. So as you can see, my desired domain name, which is helpmecreatemyblog.com, is available and it's ready for registration. Here you can use your Google account to sign in, or you can also enter your basic information like first name, last name, country, address, email address, etc. Once you have entered all this account information, scroll down and you will see the package information. Here you can check and confirm if you have selected the right hosting plan. If not, you can change it here. For the hosting plan term, I'll highly recommend you to choose the maximum time period, as that way you will be able to save the maximum amount of money. For example, if you select for 12 months, the overall amount you will be paying is low, but on per month basis, you end up paying a higher amount. So instead of that, choose 36 months, as that way the monthly hosting price will be the lowest. And once you are done with this, scroll down and you'll see package extras. Here you can select the additional add-ons if you need for your WordPress blog or website. I don't need all these extra functionalities, so I'll uncheck the box next to each. As I uncheck the box next to each of these, you can see that the total amount I'll be paying is decreasing substantially. And once I'm happy with the total amount, I'll scroll down where I'll need to enter my payment information. You can enter your debit or credit card information here. If you want to pay with PayPal, you can do that as well. Simply click this More Payment option, and this will provide you with the option to pay using PayPal. Now I'll fast forward this as I'm entering my payment information. Once done with all these, scroll down and click this checkbox to agree with terms and conditions. Finally, click Submit and your hosting account will be created. Alright, once the transaction is done, you will see a success message like this. Simply click this Create Your Account button, and this will take you to the new page where you need to create a password and retype the password. I would use this suggested password and then click this checkbox that says I have read and agreed to privacy policy and terms of services. Finally, click Create Account, and now your hosting account is ready. Now you can log into this account with the new password that you just created. And once you are logged in, you'll see a welcome tour with some basic questions like this. I'll skip all these steps and fast forward it to save your time. It'll also prompt you to pick a theme for your new WordPress blog. You may choose any of the free or premium themes available here. But since I don't want to spend money on a premium theme right away, so I'll choose a free theme here. Let's choose this one and use this theme. And as you can see, the installation is in progress. So wait for a few moments and it'll be soon ready. Alright, now the installation is completed and we are on the dashboard of our hosting account. From the left menu items, go to My Sites, and this will take you to the new page where you can manage your sites. Now click this Manage Site button and you'll see an overview of your site. Here you get the various options to manage marketing, users, backups, performance, security, plugins, etc. But what we are really concerned about is this settings option. Click on that and then change the site URL. Now I'll type my domain name here and also check this box that says update home URL to match site URL. This is very crucial, as this will update the domain name from a temporary URL to a brandable permanent domain URL that we recently purchased. And once done, click Save Updates button to save the changes made. When you see this success message, it's all done and we are ready to proceed to WordPress admin area of our blog. So click this Login to WordPress button and this will take you to your WordPress dashboard. And when you are on the WordPress dashboard, you can hover over this plus new button and you'll get various options to choose whether you want to create a post, media, page or user account. If you want to create a blog post, you'll choose this post option, or you can also do that alternatively by scrolling and clicking on this link that says write your first blog post. And when you click that, it'll take you to WordPress blog editor with a welcome guide. It's pretty self-explanatory and you can learn the basic working of WordPress editor with this welcome guide. Finally, click Get Started. And now you can type your blog title here and start writing the content below. And when you are done with writing, you can click this Publish button to publish your blog post. So that is how you can create your own professional WordPress blog and design it. If you want to learn how to write your first blog article, watch this video. And if you want to learn how to drive blog traffic, watch this video. And if you want to learn blogging for free, visit bloggingmasterycourse.com to sign up for 7 days free mini course.